Hey, Real Green Ninja here. The video you're about to watch is a supplement to the existing tutorials and help videos already available on the Real Green website. I do take a more casual approach because I'm presenting this information as I would if you called in, although I may have a little fun with it. This video is based upon the information I, as a Real Green technician, would provide using my experience on the help desk. This video was created on my own time to assist with areas of the software that may be waiting for an official help video or tutorial. At the beginning of the training video, I will have the version of the service assistant the video was made with. I will also try to be as accurate as possible, but be aware, as Service Assistant updates are released, things may change. I'm using the name Real Green Ninja as not to stand out from the other amazing technicians that I work with. I hope the information in this video helps you, so grab a cup of coffee, and I hope you learn something new. Hey, Real Green Ninja here. This is going to be the first in a series of videos discussing parameter screens and what other screens they affect. Today, we're going to talk about the company branch setup that's located under company parameters. So, let's begin. So, we're going to go to data, then company parameters, and company branch setup. Inside this screen, this is where you're going to set up options for how your company shows to your customers. For example, you indicate what the branch name is. This is the name that will be printed on statements and invoices, and so on and so forth. You're going to put the address. This would be your address again that's going to be showing on statements or invoices. Now, you may not be routing your trucks out from this address. A normal example I have, a lot of times that people come and talk about, is what it is they actually send the trucks out from their house, because there might be a single owner operator, and they actually have their customers send in their statements and payments and stuff like that to their mailing address, which might be a P.O. box. So if you do have that situation where your trucks are actually going from a different address than your mailing address, what you want to do is you want to change this or have this as your depot address, as we call it, geocode it by clicking on this little globe here, which will then give it a latitude longitude. Once you've done that, you'll come back in here and put your mailing address and then save it. That way, your trucks are actually being routed from the depot address, but your customers are sending their statements and payments and stuff like that to your mailing address. This is also where you put in your phone numbers, fax numbers, if you have to show a license number on certain print products, as well as default tax codes when you're setting up customers and default state and default area code. Most fertilization companies, or most lawn care companies, normally use 1,000 square feet. This is where you're going to put your default units of measure, as well as you can put in a reply to email address. Now, be aware, though, anybody that sends out email through Service Assistant, either using the new feature that they added about a year or so ago, using it under the company setup, and then the server file and info under the general setup tab and all that stuff, if you're sending it through the software, or if you're even using Outlook and you're sending email through Outlook, be aware this is the reply email address is what's going to show up when that customer receives it. It's not necessarily the same as the email address that's sending it. There are some email providers out there that will block an email if the reply to and the sending address are different. So that is one thing to keep aware of, because I've also heard from the AMA that they actually need a reply to email address. So it's one of those things where I'm not exactly sure what's going to happen. Again, I'm just kind of giving you guys a heads up on that reply to email address has been blocked by some providers if it's different from the sending address. Okay, this is also where you can put in your company website. Now, if you just type in your website here and you don't put the HTTP, when you go to save it or when you go to a different tab or different field, it's going to then ask you, well, do you want to put HTTP in front of it? And again, that's up to you. You can also go to the website just to make sure you got the right URL in there. This is also where you're going to put in your default invoice message. If you ever have to reset that invoice screen, this is the message that's going to default into that first slot. So again, you can set whatever you want. You can even create like a blank one and call it blank and then have that, by default. But again, you want at least something in there. So you might put like aeration with price or whatever. Again, whatever you're trying to sell. I'll do lawn care checklist. This is also where CAW will set up things like your merchant ID and terminal ID to allow you to process credit cards, as well as if you do get signed up with APR or TSI, which are two collection agencies we work with, that you can actually send information from Service Assistant electronically to those collection agencies, and then also grab information from them. This is where you're going to put in those ID numbers. This is also where you can put in your logo as well as your letterhead. Usually the logo is just a picture. Your letterhead might be the picture, but a smaller size, and then have things like your contact information, you get your mailing address, phone number, that sort of thing. So let me show you here real quick how to change a logo if you need to change it or even load it initially. Again, this is one of those things that you might do once and not touch it for 5 years. So what you're going to do is you're going to go into edit mode. You're going to hit this little edit button up here. You're going to click somewhere in the box of either the logo or letterhead that you want to change. And then I like to clear it out just to make sure, but also make sure you have a copy of the original just in case you want to put it back in there. But you can clear it out, and then again, I'm just make sure I click in there, and I'm going to open up the new logo I want to add. Now, if you open it up and it says across here that says the photo viewer, you're not going to be able to import it. You actually need to open it up in something like Paint so you can edit it. So what you're going to want to do is, let me scroll this down here so I can show you. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to right click it, and then you're going to want to click on Edit, and it's going to open it up in a Paint program. So you'll see now it actually has things where I can actually change colors and so on and so forth. But while you're in this edit mode, you're going to click Control A, and it says Select All. You now see there's a dotted line around it. Control C for copy. And again, it's copied to your computer's clipboard. Now that it's on my computer's clipboard, I can go through and I can click in. I'm going to click somewhere in this box just to make sure. I'm going to do Edit, Paste Special, Picture Meta File. We click OK here, it's going to throw that logo. Now, if you go to save it and that picture disappears, that means that picture might be a little bit too big for the area that the system stores it in. So let's see if mine's too big or not. Okay, we're good. Again, but if it disappears, all you really need to do is go back into the editing program. You should still be in it. You can go back into that Paint program and maybe do something like a resize. Click on resize, maybe reduce it by 50% or something like that, and again, then try to bring it in. I always recommend if you're looking at resizing or manipulating the pictures and stuff, make a copy of it, again, just in case something gets messed up, you know, and you accidentally save it, you don't want to lose your original. And again, your letterhead, you can put your letterhead in there. Now down here in the mapping assistant settings, you can put in your start and stop time for your workday, what your normal lunch is, as well as lunch length time. You can also create what are called custom maps. It's a little bit more advanced feature in the software. It's not something I'm going to go into today because, again, I'm just talking about the company branch info. As far as the market and region tabs, those are tabs that are actually used by large companies. They have multiple franchises, maybe 100 different divisions and stuff like that. It's not something most people are really going to have to worry about or need to use, at least right now. I mean, obviously, we hope out here at Real Green there will be at some point in time that you will get large, you will get huge, and you would need to use one of these tabs or some of these features for some larger companies. But again, right now, it's not something you have to really worry about too much. So I hope this helps, and you guys have yourself a wonderful day.